This will soon be behind us, and we'll be off on a grand adventure. Because I have cleared my calendar for you. You and I are gonna tear shit up!
Sometimes video games create enemies who are more likable than the protagonist. This is probably because games try to make the protagonist a blank slate so the player can project themselves on them. It's not hard for writers to create someone more interesting than a generic action hero. A good example of this would be Voss from Far Cry 3. While he clearly is the enemy, having tortured you and killed your brother, he has moments of brilliance that really stick with you.
But the definition of insanity is... Insanity is doing the exact same fucking thing over and over again. Expecting shit to change. That is crazy.
So, will the next game's antagonist be as memorable as the previous? Well, let's see. Far Cry 4 is the fourth installment of the action-adventure first-person shooter series developed by Ubisoft. You play as Ajay Gale, a young man who's traveling to the fictional country of Karat to bring his mother's ashes there as her last wish. His bus gets stopped by the Karate military, and he is met face-to-face with Karat's king and the primary antagonist, Paigon Min. You escape capture and meet up with the Golden Path, a revolutionary group fighting against Paigon Min's tyranny. Far Cry 4's setting of Karat is very similar to Nepal in the Himalayas. Since much of the area is mountainous and forested, you get around by ziplining and mountain climbing. Once you've discovered location, you can quick travel to the different places you've been to. I find quick travel breaks your immersion in the game, but I think it'd be really annoying to scale up a mountainside for 5 minutes every time you need to replenish your supplies. Like in many Far Cry games, the local wildlife is a secondary enemy which can be either a hindrance or help. You can collect bait from dead animals to throw, attracting predators that will attack anyone near it. This kind of feels like calling for reinforcements. Except they're ravenous beasts who don't like you either. One of the biggest selling points to the game is the character of Paigon Min, featured heavily in trailers and on the game cover. Paigon Min is a crazy, maniacal, twisted man who rules Karat with a combination of military strength and propaganda. However, his flair really shines and makes him a likable character.
Would you hold this? For just a moment, I want to get a little... right into the camera. There we are. Awesome.
However, after the intro cutscene, you hear from him again, not angry that you left the dinner he ordered for you.
Ajay, my boy, are you busy? You don't mind me calling, do you? Fantastic. You really are an excellent listener. Look, no hard feelings about the crab rangoon. I know it's not to everyone's taste, but you'll be pleased to know I had the chef executed for his incompetence. Or was it his family we killed?
I feel like the developers try to make Paigon Min as likable as possible to almost a degree of forcing it. I remember overhearing a rumor that you can beat the game in 10 minutes. Apparently, when Paigon Min says,
"Don't move, I will be right back."
If you wait for 10 minutes, he comes back and you see an alternate ending. I mean, realistically, when a man who has a whole army under his control and kills his own soldiers because they almost killed you asks you to wait a minute, I'd wait a minute. That's just common courtesy. Wait, what? He returns. Seriously? Damn. Oh, okay, well, better not spoil too much of the game. Far Cry 4 is available on Steam, PlayStation 3 and 4, and Xbox 360 and 1.
Maybe now we can finally shoot some goddamn guns.